Hello, it's Vidas Pinkevičius here. And in this video you will only see my both feet, because today I'm going to show you how to play the C major scale over one octave correctly. The foundations of the scale playing and one octave playing, and how you can correctly play easily any scale basically, but we will start with the C major scale, okay? So, the principle is this. You sit in the middle of the keyboard, of the bench actually, and your feet should be, your toes should be touching the sharp keys, okay? Touching, not too close, not too far from the sharp keys, but slightly touching. Therefore, adjust your bench position so that the bench is exactly parallel to the keyboards and your toes are touching, okay, as you sit like that. You also should be wearing the organist shoes, okay? It's important. You don't need special kind of organist shoes, but you can find something suitable in your closet, because your organ shoes have to have special heels. Without heels you cannot really play scales successfully, because here you will not only need to play with the toes, but also you will need to use your heels. So toe heel technique is used by playing scales, and especially the C major scale. Okay, this scale does not have any accidentals, only white keys. Okay, like that, and we will use both feet together in this exercise. And the first thing you have to remember, that you have to keep your heels and knees together. Some people find it really hard to keep your knees together, so I recommend only perhaps the heels together, okay, heels, but not always, because you see, in the beginning of the scale, that the first five pitches you will be playing using your left foot alone, okay? Why is that? Because you see, it's really tricky to play with the right foot at the lower bottom of the pedal board like that. Some people can, it's not a problem for me, but most of the people really find it difficult to play at the extreme edges of the pedal board using both feet. So I recommend using only left foot alone for the five pitches, C, D, E, F, and G, okay? And the way you do this is you play by using your ankle motion. Depress the pedals from the motion of the ankle. Not by lifting your entire knee, okay, or leg. By the way, your toes and feet should be slightly touching the pedal board, okay? So if you need to adjust the organ bench, the height of the bench, go ahead and do that, so that your feet should be touching, okay, slightly resting and not pressing. If you are pressing the keys, then you are a little too low, so put something under the bench, of on both of sides of the bench, so that your bench should be a little higher than, if this is the case. All right, so now let's try the scale. We start with the left toe, okay? As you play the C note with the left toe, the note D is already prepared, okay? The D is already prepared, and the note A is already prepared for the right toe. Later on you will play right toe, and you need to prepare it in advance, okay? So C, D prepared, then you just move your toe to the next position for the note E. Do not move the right leg at all. Okay, as you play E, move the heel to the F pedal. Okay, then again to the toe on the G. One more time. C, D, E, F, G. That's not too hard actually, even for the beginners, most of the beginners, because you see, it's only the motion like this, the horizontal motion. Do not lift your feet off the pedal board at all. Try to keep the contact with the pedal keys as you play all the time. Then you will be very precise. And play your white keys close to the sharp keys also. Do not play like that. That's too wide. That's better. Okay? Okay? So, as you approach the note G, your both heels should be touching. Right and left should be touching. Because the right toe is already in place for the note A. Like that. The sixth scale degree. One more time. Like that. So, here both heels are touching. Okay? After you play the note A with the right toe, you need to do something very interesting here. You need to push both of your heels with the left heel a little bit to the right, so that your left heel will become just above the pedal B. That was the last position, GA, G and A, toe, okay, left, right. And what happens next is the next position, left heel is above the pedal B, and at the same time, the right heel is above the pedal C. One more time. Okay, like that. Be very careful so that your legato, the touch will be very smooth. So the notes should be touching and not detached in this style, legato style technique. Okay, one more time. Okay, right here. You shift to the new position with the heel. As you play B, do not move your right heel at all, because it's already in place for the note C. Okay, C right here. Then you move down with this to the bottom of the pedal board. And also, four pitches. Notice how the next four pitches are already in place. B, A, and G. One more time. G, A, B, C, B, A, G. This position is already in place. Now you just do the opposite as you started. Keep the right toe resting above the note A, but play F with the left toe, E with the left, excuse me, play the G with the left toe, and then F with the left heel, E with the left toe, heel, and toe again. Okay? Okay, horizontal movement of the ankle. By the way, the scale playing, okay, regular playing of this pedal scale, it will help you develop the flexibility of the ankle, of both feet. If you use both feet, toe and heel technique, on the scales in every key you know, like 24 different keys, major and minor, you will eventually develop flexibility of an ankle. You need to also play major and minor scales over two octaves as well, and play arpeggios of various kinds, and even scales for double pedals if you need to be a pedal virtuoso. But the key is this: play scales and regularly, and you will develop this flexibility of an ankle, which is actually the secret to the perfect pedal technique. The great French organist Marcel Dupré always emphasized playing scales and arpeggios with the feet, and once also wrote that the secret to the great and perfect pedal technique is exactly the same: flexibility of an ankle. And pedal scale playing is so much underused, and not too many people practice it nowadays. And if you knew this secret and great benefit from playing the scales, you should be practicing your scales every day for a few months, okay? And after that, you will notice tremendous improvement in your pedal technique, okay? So, one last time, C major scale for you, very slowly. Okay, so that's the basics of the C major pedal scale playing, and I hope you repeat this exercise like perhaps 10 times in a slow tempo, perhaps slower than I do, and feel comfortable in a slow tempo, and only as you get a little better and better each time, you can speed up the tempo a little bit more. And so if your organ allows, try to use a clear registration, perhaps even without the 16-foot stop, as is in my organ. It could be principal or flutes of 8 and 4 foot, and keep the smooth legato when playing scales, okay? So happy practicing, and I'll see you in the next video.